Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Today I will show you how you can make your own page using the Beaver Builder page builder. First, when we have enabled the plugin and the theme, we will see a button up at the top that says Page Builder, and we click on that. Now it will ask us to select a template, and we will just choose blank, because we will be building this page from scratch. Now you can see there's a menu at the right with all kinds of different modules. So we will start by dragging a column onto the page. And inside that column, we'll want some text. So we drag text editor into that. And we'll just take our sample text and put it into there. And before we get any further with the page builder, we will have to look at some theme customization. So go to the top right where it says done and click it, publish changes. This will take us back to our page, and now we can go and customize the theme. Whenever we change something inside of the page builder, we are only doing it to that content inside of that page. But if we do it inside the theme customizer, it will affect your whole site. So every page on that site will have changed page background if you change your background inside of the theme customizer. So for example, if we go to general, background, and choose another background color, maybe a darker gray, it will now change the background on all the pages. But as you might have noticed, it has not changed the whole background, only this at the bottom. And that is because there's also, of course, the content background. Inside content and content background, so I'm gonna make that this red gray, so we can still tell the difference from the gray background. And now we can still see there's still a white background going on, and that is because it's our header and footer inside the theme. I don't want this content background, so I'm gonna set the opacity to 0. And I'm gonna go back. But now it's hard to read the text on the side. So I wanna set a content background only for this box. So I'm gonna go to save and publish. Exit the customizer and click the page builder icon. So now I can edit the background for only this box by going here at the top and clicking row settings. So now I will scroll down to background and set it to color, and I will choose white and press save. And now for the header. So I'm going to click done once again and publish changes. This header and footer right here are the theme's header and footer, which means I will not be able to edit them using Beaver Builder. So I'm going to customize and header style, header layout, and set none if I want it removed. And fixed header, that means it will still appear if I scroll down, and I don't want that either. and I'm gonna go back and footer, and same with the footer, I'm gonna say none. So this way I can customize my own header and footer inside Viewer Builder. So once again, press Page Builder. And we're gonna need a new row to put content in. So I'm gonna click on Row Layouts. And I want two columns this time. And I'm gonna put that at the bottom because I want it to be my footer. And here you can see that there's two boxes, that's because I selected two columns. So in these boxes I'm gonna put whatever I want to appear on each page. So I'd probably want some contact information, so I'm gonna take the text editor and drag it into one of the boxes and fill out that and press save. And right now there's gray on gray, but I can change the background anytime I want, so we're just gonna add the content first. And in the other one I want a map to appear, so it's under advanced modules and map, and drag that into the other box. And I want to put in my address there and press save. So now we have our row with our contact information and a map. So obviously we want to change the background. And I'm gonna set it to color again and just choose white. But I want this to go to the edges, so I just go to width and press full width. I also want the content to go to the edges, so I'm going to press on full width under content width. And I'm gonna leave the height at default. So to make this section appear on every page, I'm going to first save it. And I do that by going to the settings and pressing save as. And I will call it footer. And set it to global and press save. Now I'm gonna exit the Viewer Builder and say publish changes and go into my admin panel and under settings, page builder, and then BB header footer. This is a plugin for Viewer Builder, so if you don't have it, you need to download it before you can use it. It's called Viewer Builder Header Footer. And I will choose footer and press save. And now I can go back to the page. And as you can see, it has added the footer once more to this and all the other pages. So we don't need this one anymore. So just remove it, and whenever you need it to edit it again, you can go under Save Rows and drag it out on your page, and you can edit it, and once you're done editing you can remove it again. You can use the same method for creating a header that you want on all your pages. And I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. See you in the next one.